Hello, this is Deborah, aka DD Charles here, and I do appreciate you stopping by this video. If this is your first time ever seeing me on video or here on YouTube, then go ahead and hit the like and subscribe button below this video so that when I come on to do these videos, I won't miss you and you won't miss me. And in case you're on Facebook and you're seeing me over there, then go ahead and give me some thumbs ups, some hearts, and some shares. And also leave me a message so that I will be able to get back and interact with you once the video is over. So my name is Deborah Charles. I am the CEO of Social Media Marketing with Debc, where I help other struggling home-based business owners, newbie marketers, affiliate marketers, network marketers on how to leverage their Facebook profile to get leads and sales, guys, for your business. Because as a marketer, that is the number one thing that we need, along with a system that we can, start gathering up leads for our business. Tonight, we're going to be talking about content marketing. And this is also in relations with your Facebook profile because you have to have good content that you are providing for your audience in order for them to, to get to know the things that you're trying to help them with. So when it comes to content, the one thing, as I just stated, that you have to keep in mind is your audience. What is it that they want resonate with you the most? And let me ask you this. Have you ever stopped and taken an inventory or an audit of your Facebook profile? And meaning that you went down through it and you looked at those that content that you have already put on your Facebook wall, I mean profile, and then you make a no make it a list of the maybe it was a video or maybe an image or some written content that you did, and you looked at it to see and you measured which one of those areas that your audience was resonating with you. Like you may have had a video, and that particular video may have been liked, or the hearts and shares have been done more than on a image or on any other your content. So that should be an indication to you that that is what your audience really like, that you do on your content for them, and that's the thing that they want to see that you put on there. So tonight I want to give you some simple ways you can do a checkup on your on your wall or on your Facebook profile, and to help you to kind of get that content that your audience is looking for. So the first thing is making sure that the content you share is something that you know about, that you really are familiar with. It could be about some experiences that you have had and that you share that your audience can resonate with, and it shows you as the authority figure in that content, or what, how you're sharing it, how your expertise, I would say. So and you could do this by using your, again, your experiences to help you with driving the point home. There might be some things that you can, your story might be something that they can resonate with that help you to to get the point over to them what you're talking about. The second one, you need to be very informative so that when your readers have questions about the content that you're offering, you can answer them in a very professional way. You can do this by using, we all know about keyword search. So you can do some keyword searches on some, because when I, let me go back a little bit. When I say you can do this by keyword search, if you are in connection with your audience, you pretty much know what they are looking for, or they will let you know. And like I said, through those that audit that you did on your profile. So You could ask questions. You could do surveys to know, ask them what is it that they want you to, you know, content that they would like for you to talk to them about or give them. So you could take that content and get, you know, do keyword searches on it so that you can be able to answer the questions that your audience might be asking about that particular content, if you know what I'm saying. So, and then you need to know what your purpose is, the purpose of what it is, why are you getting this particular piece of content to share with your audience? What's the purpose of it? And the purpose should be to help your audience to find out what the pain point is that they have, and you be the solution for that pain point. You hear that all the time when from other marketers is saying that you need to know who your audience is and the pain points are the things that they are having a problem with, and you be the solution for that. So that's the second one. The third one, it needs to be understandable. Now, not all people understand and comprehend things like you may do. So you have to make it relatable to your audience so that they can be able to pick up on what you're saying, and you can say it with the understanding that at the level that they are and with clarity. So you want to be able to, convey some things to them where it won't be just over their heads. You know what I'm saying? So that's the third one. The fourth one is, what is your point? Okay, what is your point of view? I mean, you should have a point of view. So you want to look for content that give fresh ideas and points of view to your audience, where the information may have been given, affiliate marketing, I use that word. Well, when we come on, we talk about affiliate marketing, and basically your audience probably have heard that over and over again. So you want to give your a fresh view to your audience of what affiliate marketing really is and how it works. And then you want to put your personality on it. You want to be, if you're a bubbly kind of person, then you put your personality into that. If you someone like me that use your hands to talk, which I should be doing, you could do that, but that's part of your personality. So you want to understandable, you want to be relatable, and you want to be show your personality to your audience through your content. And then you want to satisfy your audience, with your content. Satisfying means that you are constantly giving them things that answer their question or provide a solution to a problem that they may have, and they are satisfied with it enough that they keep returning back to you for some more content. So guys, I hope that this has been some help to you. And if it has and you find value in it, then go ahead and share it out with someone else that you might think need this information. And also, as I always say below this video, I want to share with you my number one way of how I make income online. And it's not hard. I won't say it's easy, but it's not hard to do. If you are coachable and if you have a desire to move from where you are in your life and you want to have a different way of making income and sometimes freedom from just being, going to work on a 9-to-5 job, then below the video is a simple way that you can get started. And also, once you get started with the business, I always like to be transparent and tell people, once you get started, there are some additional things that you need to do as well. And you need tools to help you to automate, because if you are working on a job, sometimes that's a hindrance. So you want to have some tools there that can help you to automate your stuff so that while you're at work, you're still making money. So guys, this has been your girl Deborah Charles down here in Pine Bluff, Arkansas, and I hope that you have a blessed night, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Have a great, great evening. Bye-bye.